Are you using a webcam, but the image just isn't right? Maybe you're completely underexposed because you've got bright lights behind you or a white wall, or the color is off, or something's just not right. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to a software plugin for your Mac that can solve most of these issues. So the software is called iGlasses, and there's a link down below that you can use to purchase this software if you're interested. Here's the gist of it. It is able to do a whole bunch of things to your webcam feed so that if you're using QuickTime or if you're using, in my case, ScreenFlow, or you're doing video conferencing, you can do a bunch of changes. So let me show you some of the things that it can do and you know how I've fixed the video that I'm experiencing right now. So the first thing is, if you open iGlasses, you need to select the webcam. So I am using the C922. And I gotta mention that Logitech makes a free software that does many of the things here. Check out this other video, I'll have a link at the end, and that way you can see the options that you can get for free over there. I'll talk in this video about one of the limitations of the iGlasses. So choose the webcam that you want to work with. And then you've got a number of different options here. So I always go to the adjustments tab and I turn off everything, or I turn off the auto white balance and the auto exposure. So what this is doing is, you know, right now it's trying to expose for kind of a mix of me and behind me. So behind me is just way too bright. I'm just way too dark. So what I'm trying to do is make it so that I am properly exposed, but behind me is overexposed. So I'm going to click on the exposure here. It's kind of tweak it up a little bit and see how it's going. It looks like I've gone a little bit too far. Go back just a little bit more. There we go. So I'm looking pretty good, pretty properly exposed. You can also change the white balance. So sometimes when you're in this situation, you're either looking too blue or too green or too yellow. You can go through here and change the white balance. So this will making me a little more blue. That's a little too blue. This is kind of, I think, is going to take me up into the kind of super yellow. So just work your way around here until you find what you think looks the best. And you can also decide if you want it to be accurate or if you want it to be oversaturated. You've got some choices there. So then you've got a number of choices up here in terms of ways to change kind of some of the same things, but just a different way of doing it. And I want to go into a couple of the other features here. So zoom and flip, you can have it, you know, be rotated so that it's sideways or upside down. You can mirror it so it's backwards. You can go into these funky effects if you wanna. This is kind of more Snapchatty type stuff. So let's see here if I can do a frog. I don't know if it's gonna keep my, yeah, there we go. So, you know, kind of the fun things that you wanna do with your webcam. I'm gonna see here, how do I turn this off now? Go back to normal. What? Oh, normal's in the middle. You've got some presets that you can set here, or you can click save your current settings. So if you know that you're always in front of this window, you can save it so that it always has the settings. You can just pop it in there and turn it on. Now, I want to talk about the limitation here, and you're kind of seeing it a little bit in the screen there, is that this is a processor hog. So I'm using a MacBook Pro that's a few years old, and I'm going to pull up my activity monitor here and let you see what's going on. This is what's going on, is it is really chugging away on the processor trying to process these changes into my video. So that can be a problem if you're trying to do something live streaming. So it can be a little bit tricky here. So often when you're doing something with your webcam, if you're doing a screen recording or if you know you're doing using Skype or something like that, there's a bunch of processor intensive things. And what I found is that iGlasses can add to that intensiveness. So sometimes it might push your computer to the limit. And that's one of the things with, if you have a Logitech camera, I have found that that has not been a problem using the Logitech software. And go ahead, you can click over here now to see that. Once again, down below, you can get a link to buy iGlasses if you're interested in that. Otherwise, I'll see you in the next video.